Hello everyone. In the last video, we have already discussed about the basic type of operators and left some questions for checking your progress. And if you have already solved the problem, then it is well and good. And if you are facing some problems to find out the remainder, if we are using the negative values in the numerator or denominator, then this video is for you. And we are trying to find out the remainder if the numerator or denominator or both of the numerator or denominator contains the negative values. In this video, the first question is 24 modulus minus 9. So normally in mathematics, we know that if we are trying to find out the numerator, then the numerator is equals to the denominator multiplied by quotient plus r. This is the basic fundamental concept of the mathematics. And if you are trying to find out the remainder of the negative values, then you have to follow these some techniques we are going to discuss. And here, for some time, you just have to forget about the negative sign or positive sign of the numbers. And just follow me that how we are calculating the remainder of the negative values. So here we have to find out the quotient first. Okay, so the denominator is d and the quotient is q. So denominator, we know that it is a minus 9. So forget about the negative sign right now and just have to take the denominator value is 9. And if I will put here the 9, then we have to find out the q. And the value of q should be minimum so that the 24 should be less than equals to d into q. So in this case, if I will take here the quotient is 3, then 24 will be less than or equals to 27. That is right. Now we have to follow this rule that for finding out the remainder, if the quotient contains the negative values for the numerator or denominator, then we have to take here the denominator multiplied by minus of quotient plus r. So this time we have calculated the value of q is 3, then we have to put here the minus of q, and the q is 3. So put here the denominator. Denominator is this time the minus 9. So minus 9 multiplied by minus of q. And we have calculated here the value of q is 3. So there is the minus of 3. So minus 9 multiplied by minus 3 and plus r. So this time we have to find out the value of r. So after the calculation of this equation, we will get here the 24 is equals to minus 9 multiplied by minus 3 is 27 and plus r. So finally we will get here the r is equals to 24 minus 27 and get the result minus 3. Right? Let's see the another question. And in this question, we have taken here the numerator as a negative values. So in that situation, how we will find the remainder? So basic concept is same. Here we have to just have to forget about the sign, that here we have taken the negative sign. So just for some time, you just have to forget about the negative sign. Just take the value. The 30 should be less than equals to d into q. And here the denominator is 18. So we have to take the 18 multiplied by q. So the value of q this time we have taken the 2, so that the 30 should be less than equals to 18 multiplied by 2. How we will select the value of q? So the value of q should be minimum so that the 30 should be less than or equals to 18 multiplied by q. So if I will take here the q value is 1, then it becomes false. And if you will take here the 2, then 18 into 2 is 36. So the 30 is less than equals to 36 becomes true. And now come to this formula. In the previous question, we have already seen this formula that the numerator is equals to the denominator multiplied by minus of q plus r. And based on this rule, we have to put here the value. This time the numerator is minus 30. So minus 30 is equals to 18 is the denominator multiplied by minus of q, and here we have already calculated the value of q is 2. So here is the minus 2 plus r, and we will get here the minus 30 is equals to minus of 36 plus r. And finally, we will get here the value of r is equals to minus 30 plus 36, and the value of r becomes 6. Now let's see the another question here. If the numerator and denominator both contains the negative value, then what we will do? So for solving of this type of problems, this is a very simple techniques. Only we have to take the negative sign as a common. So just have to take out from the numbers. So take the negative sign out, and the numerator and denominator we have to take to find out the remainder. So whatever the remainder you will get by the value of 14 modulus 6, that is to be preceded by negative sign. So here is the remainder of 14 modulus 6 is 2, and put the negative sign before it. So we will get here the minus 2 answer, right? Hope you understand the concept of finding out the remainder of the negative values. And if you like this video, then please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get the latest update of my videos. Thank you.